I, for me, the thing about the rocks is that they're very flexible, and they're not. I wouldn't say they're hi-fi speakers. I would say they're studio speakers. I would say that they're very much, you know, you can turn them up loud and they'll cope with it, but they won't flatter what you do. I bought the 5-1 system that I have because I was doing Interstellar with Hans Zimmer, and Hans had said, I want to monitor in 5-1 because Chris Nolan, the director, and he had developed a way of working on the films whereby what Chris hears as we're recording it is crafted as we're recording it. And he then wants to be able to have exactly that when he gets back to the dub. The Rock and the Avalanche sub were the ideal combination of that gave me the full breadth, allowed me to turn it up, but at the same time were, you know, manageable in terms of the logistics of the process. So I, you know, was looking for a set of speakers that would give me the difference between the flattering big speakers down to the small stuff, allow me to work at a lower volume so I'm not deafening myself but still hear all the detail. And to my ear, they do a great job of allowing you to sit for 16 hours in front of something that's telling you what you need to know. It's not tiring to listen to, it's not too flattering. It just gives you the information you need to make intelligent decisions about the mixes and the recording balances and stuff that you're coming up with.